Welcome, everybody. This is DJ Benny James. It's Friday, the 17th of January, 2020. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing, thank you for pressing play. For the next hour, we're going to be playing some amazing Motown music. Now, if you're young, you might not know what Motown is. And if you're more mature, like me, then obviously you know the classic Motown music. Artists include Stevie Wonder, Jackson 5, Marvin Gaye, The Supremes, Temptations, Smokey Robinson, and plenty, plenty more. Now on this show, I'm going to be focusing on, I guess, the classics, the older Motown. Because Motown went on for years and years, so there's some newer Motown too, so I'm going to play the classics, why not? So we'll call it part one, shall we? Now the music came out of Detroit, Michigan. And the founder was Berry Gordy. Now, Detroit was famous for making cars, for building cars. And it was actually dubbed Motor City. And actually, Berry Gordy was actually one of the workers on the assembly line in one of those factories. And he was a songwriter and always had aspirations to start his own record label. So what I read was he got a loan of $800 from his friends and family and purchased a small property, just looked like a house with a garage, and built a studio in the back and hired the most amazing local musicians and basically used the concept of the assembly line idea to just churn out hit after hit after hit after hit. And Motown today is still an absolute legacy. And the music just still lives on today. So I'm glad you're here with me today. Because I'm going to talk a little bit about Motown and also play all the great songs for you. The wifey just went out to the shops, so it gave me an hour free time, and the school gets out in an hour too, so I've just got enough time to squeeze this show in for you. So I'm glad you're here. And you can enjoy this with me. I got my headphones on. I'm standing here in my gym clothes from this morning still. But I don't care. We're going to do this. All right, here's some Stevie Wonder for you. Signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Absolute classic. Enjoy.
Oh, yeah, baby. Like a fool, I went and stayed too long. I'm wondering if your love's still strong. Ooh, baby.
Yeah.
incredible sounds of Stevie Wonder. And here's a song that Berry Gordy wrote right here. I didn't know he wrote this one. He also wrote ABC as well. I Want You Back, Jackson 5. Classic Motown. Tell you what, whenever I'm doing a 70s party, I play that and people love it and they still remember the moves. Do you guys remember the moves for that one? I hope so. Here's another classic, Dancing in the Street, Martha Reeves and the Vandellas. This was an absolute major hit for Motown.
In
That's right. And actually, Berry Gordy, one of his aims was for Motown music not to be black music, not to be white music, but for music for everybody. That was what he really, really wanted. Watch some videos of him, some interviews of him, really interesting, his perspective on the music. And he did not want to have that race identity with his music that he was putting out. So amazing. Okay, next artist I'm going to play is the Supremes, and this one is Baby Love. Now, obviously, this is a massive hit, but actually, the Supremes, when they first started with Motown, they put out a few records, and they weren't really that big until later on. But this is one of their biggest hits. I'm going to have to send that one out to Donna, actually. Hopefully, Donna, you forgive me now because I finally play some Diana Ross for you. I'm going to send this one out to my wifey. She absolutely loves this song. Whenever I'm out and I'm starting a set and I play this song, she does this little jiggle. Shoulders get moving. Hips start moving. And she just loves this song. It's Marvin Gaye, of course. Track is called Gotta Get It On. Classic Motown, of course.
I'm not afraid to
Yes, indeed. You guys remember a few years ago that track Blurred Lines by Robin Thicke and Pharrell? What a Marvin Gaye Foundation actually were trying to sue them because they said they were using elements of this song without permission. I don't know what happened with that court case. I'm not too sure who won that. But they definitely sound similar, but I don't think it's a sample. I think they just adapted it. I've got to give a big shout out as well to Mom. That's M-O-M. That's Motown on Mondays. It's a soul night in lots of different cities, actually. I first found out about this and played it once in Honolulu. But I believe they also have it in L.A., Seattle, Oakland, California, Reno, California, and San Francisco, if I'm not wrong. So if you're ever out and about in the U.S. in one of those cities and you want to hear some good Motown music, look out for Mom, M-O-M, okay? Motown on Mondays. Here's some Smokey Robinson and the Miracles. You really got a hold on me. Enjoy. If you notice with a lot of the Motown music, it really has a similar feel to it. And the main reason for that is the musicians were a group of musicians that were called the Funk Brothers. They were the house band for Motown, and they produced hit after hit after hit. So even if it was different singers that they had coming into Motown to perform, they had the house band there. And these guys obviously got to gel and got to know each other so well. And they said it was just like a family at Motown. Everybody kind of knew each other. And they said that it was very secretive as well. Like if they were making songs, they would close the door. They would make sure that nobody was outside listening. They said it was amazing, an amazing time. And also the writers as well. You had had Brian and Eddie Holland and Lamont Dozier, and they just wrote so many hits. I think just for the Supremes alone, they had 8 number ones in a row. And Smokey Robinson, who was just singing right there, he was one of the main writers as well. And a lot of the artists used to go to Smokey and ask if he could write a hit for them as well. So really, really interesting. All right, here's another Motown classic for you. I can't help myself. Sugar Pie, Honey Bunch. This is the Four Tops, of course. Classic, classic. I've got sunshine. Sounds of the Temptations. On a cloudy day. When it's cold outside, I've got the month of May. Yeah.
one man can claim. Well, I guess if you say, what can make me feel this way? My girl, my girl, my girl, talking
I tell you, that brings back so many memories from me, that song. I used to DJ on a military base in London, and I remember at the end of the night, I'd always play classic soul and Temptations, and that was one of the ones, all the guys at the end of the night, they'd be drunk, and they'd all line up, and they'd do the Temptations dance, and it was hilarious, and I'll always remember that for the rest of my life, man. Great memories, great memories. Like I said, that was called My Girl, Temptations. And this one is called My Guy, Mary Wells. You know this one, ladies.
Closer and it's easy to trace all the tracks of mine. Let's get it on. Sugar, let's get it on. Woo-hoo. We're all sensitive people with so much to give. Understand me, sugar. Since we got to be here, let's live. I love you.
Of course, Marvin Gaye, Let's Get It On, one of the most timeless tracks of all time. One of the highest grossing albums of all time. And one of the important things to Berry Gordy, actually, was controlling the public image of his artists, and that would include the way they dressed, their manners, their choreography of their acts when they were on stage. He just wanted everything to be just perfect with all of his artists, you know, have a certain kind of quality. And that's what he did, man. And like I said, it goes back to that assembly line. Not only did he have the writers writing hits again and again and again, so they kind of sounded familiar to you. He had the musicians, the same musicians that sounded familiar to you. And he had this way that he wanted his artists to act, their manners, the way they dress, their choreography. So there was kind of familiarity there. And like I said, it goes back to family, and it goes back to just knowing what you're going to get when you heard a Motown song. Gordy was actually inducted to the Hall of Fame in 1998 as well, and well deserved. That's all I can say. Amazing. Here's another classic, Uptight. Everything's All Right, Stevie Wonder.
cause my heart is true. She said, baby, everything is alright.
I'm so lucky I met Stevie Wonder a few years ago. That was an amazing experience. And can you believe he started recording with Motown when he was just 11 years old? Wow.
Jimmy. Oh, Jimmy Mac.
Here's some Martha Reeves and the Vandells. Jimmy Mac. I'm going to dedicate that one to my wifey. She just got back from shopping. And she said, as she was driving past McDonald's and a magnet pulled her into McDonald's and got her some food. Now that's ridiculous, because we went to the gym this morning and now we're going to put all those calories right back on again. Lovey, you seriously are not helping. Anyway, here's some Temptations for you. Just My Imagination.
Ooh. stray through my window, I watch her as she passes by. I say to myself, you're such a lucky guy to have a girl like her. It's truly a dream come true. Out of all the fellas in the world, she belongs to you. But it was just my imagination running away with me. It was just my imagination.
Beautiful song. And actually Motown and its subsidiaries was actually the highest grossing African American business. It was just phenomenal, amazing, and actually ended up selling, Berry Gordy actually ended up selling it for over $60 million. Let me get that right. And yeah, just shows the success there. What a legacy. And what music was just going to live on forever. If you want to contact me, you can always contact me through the studio line. You can text me 856-295-1753. If you want to email me, comment, suggestions, you're more than welcome. You can email me at bennyjames@mac.com. And this podcast is pretty much available on all platforms as well. So you can find it on iTunes, Spotify, iHeartRadio. Tune in radio, you can just talk to Alexa and ask Alexa to play the podcast, Google Podcasts, Stitcher, and I'm still waiting on Pandora. I don't know what's going on with Pandora. I'm still waiting on that. And yeah, you can become a sponsor too. If you want to become a sponsor, I'd really, really appreciate it. And to my existing sponsors and those that recently signed up, I just really, really appreciate you. It's really helping advance this show, and hopefully we can reach a broader and broader audience all over the world. So I appreciate you guys. I really do. Here's some more Marvin Gaye for you. And this is called What's Going On. And it's interesting because when I was watching these documentaries on Motown, Berry Gordy was saying that in the beginning, he just wanted to make these real, just huge hits, these pop hits that would be fun and easy to learn and listen to by everybody, white and black alike. But once Motown really became established, and once the war started happening, Vietnam War, and there was a lot of strife, a lot of poverty and race riots and stuff, a lot of artists started to really write about social issues. So this is an absolute classic, obviously, that captured a moment in that time. So listen, what's going on, Marvin Gaye?
Mother, there's too many of you to cry. Brother, there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Yeah. Father, we don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer. For only love can conquer hate.
You know we've got to find a way
to bring some loving here today. Oh. Picket lines and picket signs. Don't punish me with brutality. Talk to me so you can see. Don't punish me with brutality. Come on, talk to me. You can see what's going on. Yeah, what's going on? Tell me what's going on. I'll tell you what's going on.
Right, right on. Right on.
All right, all right. We're about out of time. Just about enough time for one more song. But I just wanted to say thank you for tuning in. I really appreciate it. Not tuning in, but pressing play. I keep thinking I'm on the radio. I guess that's a good thing. Anyway, if you want to find out more about Motown, there is this movie you can download called Standing in the Shadows of Motown. Or you can look at the different clips on YouTube. Or just Google on your computer the story of Motown, and there's all different things that come up. So very, very interesting. But thank you for joining me. It's been fun, and I'm glad I did this, man. I'm going to play this last one. This is a Gladys Knight tune, and I play this one last because it's funny. I used to do this DJ night a long time back. I did it for quite a long time, a couple years. And at the end of the night, there was this lady there. Her name was Mama T. Well, that's what we called her, Mama T. And she would literally demand, not ask, but demand that this be the last song of the night. And she did not like it when I played R&B and hip-hop. She really wanted that old-school soul music and the classic Motown. So she would come up to me at the end of the night. She goes, okay, it's about that time. Play that song for me and make sure this is the last one for tonight. And I say, okay, Mama T. And I'd play it for her. So this is the last one, Midnight Train to Georgia by Gladys Knight. Okay, see you guys. Hopefully you have a great week and a great weekend. And I'll be back next Friday. Okay, aloha.
For the man,
too much for the man, he couldn't make it,
so he's leaving the life he's come to know. Ooh.
He said he's going,
he said he's going back to find,
going back to find.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. What's left of his world, the world he left behind not so long ago. He's leaving,
leaving
on that midnight train to Georgia,
leaving on the midnight train.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, said he's going back,
going back to
find, to a simpler place and time.
Whenever he takes that ride,
oh, you see him,
he's right by his side.
Now, train to Georgia,
leaving on that midnight train to Georgia.
Hey. I'd rather live in his world than live without him in mine.
That world is his and hers alone.
He kept dreaming,
dreaming,
ooh, that someday he'd be a star,
a superstar, but he didn't get far.
But he sure found out the hard. The dreams don't always
dreams don't
come true.
Always come
oh no.
True. No.
So he pawned all his hopes.
Ooh, ooh,
and he even sold his old car. Bought a one-way ticket back to the life he once knew. Oh, yes, he did. He said he would. Said he's going back to find,
going ooh, back to find
a simpler place and time.
Take that ride.
Oh,
guess who's gonna be right
yeah.
by his side?
And I'm gonna be with him.
I know he will.
Oh, that midnight train to Georgia.
I'd
rather live in his world than live without him. Said he's going back to find,
going back to find
a simpler place and time.
Whenever he takes that ride.
Ooh,